So we're comparing several variables here. First of all, we're comparing horizontal and vertical planting. We're looking at three different varieties, Biobel, Orleans, and Borgard. And we're also looking at irrigated and non-irrigated. So this is a plot of Borgard. This is irrigated and this is non-irrigated. And we're already seeing some differences in growth. In this row, the irrigated row, we see new leaves appearing, a good indication that they're taking off and they're growing. And here, just a bit slow in terms of growth, even though we've had some rains. So that shows the benefits of really maintaining that good soil moisture early on. So we're gonna dig up some 15-day Biobel plants. This was planted with a mechanical planter that was converted to plant the slips flat or horizontally. And so we can see that it did a very good job in laying the slip down flat. And you can see already pigmented roots indicating that already initiating at 15 days. So nice branching, and so yeah, you can see some swelling here. Very good sign that they're initiating, and that's, I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, at least 10 potential storage roots there. This really shows the advantage of laying the slips flat or horizontally, because you see there's less competition among the potential storage roots here. This will result in even sizing and more uniform grade. On the other hand, this vertically planted slip, you have the roots bunched up in the bottom of the slip here. This leads to more competition and therefore uneven sizing of the roots. So we're looking at storage root samples at 33 days from Biobel. This plant was planted horizontally by the mechanical transplanter that's converted, and this plant was planted vertically. You see a more even root development on the flat planted slip, and a rather uneven storage root development on the vertically planted slip. We expect to have maybe 8 or 9 US number one storage roots at harvest, whereas here perhaps one jumbo, maybe 3 to 4 US number one size roots at harvest, and the rest will be canners. So this shows the overall benefit of horizontal or flat planting in terms of even storage root development. So this is a 63-day-old sweet potato stand. It's a critical part of the growing season, because at this stage, we can sample the roots and be able to tell the progress of our potential yield here. Also, another critical thing to look at is looking at the vine growth, because at this stage, the vines stop growing in general and the roots start to swell. So it's really important to be able to monitor the growth development of both vines and roots. So in this trial, we're looking at the two methods of planting slips: conventional, where we generally stick the slip straight down, and the other method is a flat method, where we tend to lay the slip flat this way. Now, looking at the conventional planted slip, again, this is at 60 days, you're looking at different sizing of the roots here. This is a longer root compared to this root here. And so potentially when we harvest this at 110 days, we're gonna probably grade this as a US number one, probably another US number one, and probably that's gonna end up as a canner. So there's an uneven development of the roots using our conventional planting method. So these are root samples dug from a plant that was planted flat. So you can see a more consistent and even root development. Looking at the individual roots here, we expect to be digging probably 4 US number ones, maybe 5 at harvest, and maybe 1 or 2 canners. So as you can see, the potential gray dot for US1s increases with the flat planting method compared to our conventional. So we've been investigating the benefits of flat planting because in other locations it's been shown to really produce good quality yields, consistent sizing and yield. However, up until now, we can only do manual flat planting. So it takes a lot of labor, it takes a lot of consistency. And so the company that developed this mechanical transplanter came up with the solution. It's a bolt-in solution that is bolted into the mechanical planter. It forces the slip to lay flat as it's planted under row. And so it actually works very well in planting the slip horizontally. Now, one of our growers actually converted his transplanter to this. So he bought all the bolt-in attachments for his transplanter, and they found out that it not only helps in planting, but it keeps the soil from being disturbed so much and actually improves their planting efficiency. So this bolt-in attachment, number one, helps in planting the slip flat or horizontally. And number two, it actually improves the planting efficiency. We did a test this year on our demo plots, and we found out that this mechanical attachment for planting it horizontally actually did better than the manual transplanting. We are now at 90 days and we've dug some hills, and it shows 2 to 3 US number one size roots per hill. Typically that indicates that the crop is ready for harvest. And of all the experimental treatments we imposed on the demo test, it was irrigation that really produced the dramatic, or had the most dramatic results. In BioBell, irrigated plots had 30% more yield versus non-irrigated plots. In Borgard, it was 25% more, Orleans 30% more. So across the varieties that we used for this demo test, irrigation had the most dramatic effect in terms of improved yield and earlier yields. This year we had about 11 inches of rain. Despite that, the extra irrigation really helped in improving the yield, getting more consistency. So this is BioBell at 91 days. And as you can see, it's already jumboing or oversized roots. So typically growers harvest at 110, 120 days. So there's a benefit of being able to harvest it at 90 days. First of all, you can harvest in August and that will command a better price versus if you wait until September, October. And then there's also the fact that we're running out of stocks from last year. So August, September is really a good harvest window where you can benefit from very good prices. So if a grower can harvest 90 days in August, that will really improve his economic potential or standing.